We have a fireside chat with Mehraj Dube. He is our VP Marketing Zee News with Neeta Nair. She's Special Correspondent Impact Magazine Exchange for Media Group. I would request both of them to please come and join me on stage. Good morning, a very warm welcome to both of you. The stage is yours.
You know, being a 90s child, the word Zee News brings with it a lot of nostalgia for me, having grown up on all kinds of fabulous shows from on Zee. So I'm very, very happy to be here with Mehraj today, who represents the network, although the news side of it. Mehraj, you're part of an organization which is about 25 years old. It was one of the first networks to ride on the satellite wave in the country, and it has diversified since then and how. Tell me, as one of the oldest and one of the biggest news media companies in the country today, is it that much more difficult for you to maintain your credibility in an era of fake news and social media?
Thank you, Neeta. Thanks, E4M, for having me here at India Brand Conclave. And, you know, not just for 90s children, we also are watched by children of 2000 and the later ones. My children also watch Zee News. And yes, so legacy is a big thing. It was always difficult to be, you know, to maintain credibility and use it as a choice or choose it as a business option. And we've always chosen that. So we don't find it as a difficult thing, so to say. We see it more as a basis on which this business is built. And we go an extra mile to maintain that credibility, because now all the more, like you mentioned, there are millions of shares and fake news items on social media and otherwise. And you know, yes, we are predominantly a TV news channel, as you know, Zee News, but we're competing with every other space, because viewer doesn't really care which medium. He is interested in news and credible news. Mm-hmm. And at the end of the day, we are storytellers. So if story, who is narrating that story? Is the story true or not? It's credible, believable, all that really matters. So yes, we have to go, you know, and try a little extra every time to maintain that and to care for it.
There are, at the moment, there are about 22 national Hindi news channels in the country. And even the big ones from the English side, like Republic, have announced their foray into the Hindi news market. Is that worrisome for even an established brand like Zee?
So, yeah, maybe it makes my job or my team's job tougher, that's all. But I wouldn't really say worrisome, because we don't bother much on what others are doing. We rather focus on who we are and what are we doing, or what is the value that we are giving to our viewers, and what is the expectation that our viewer is carrying. So I think that's more important. That said, I think the viewer is, so you know, 22 or more national channels, there's just one number. What is more important is that viewers are much more smarter now. So I think as a former journalist, I could say that maybe almost 18, 20 years ago, when you were doing a news story, it was more inspired by a newspaper. You wanted to stand tall next to a newspaper, because newspaper was what TV, what people believed in. Ye chhap chuka hai, toh ye sach hai. So you always wanted to be credible, because, you know, even as a news reporter, you carry a camera to someone for an interview or something. They say, haan, maine akhbar mein padha hai, aaj ye sach hai. So they'll tell you. But gone are those days. So it's actually a storyteller's job, a journalist's job, or as an organization, our job to maintain their credibility. And it's 22 or 200 or many more to come. All the best to them. But we are here to stay, and we are here to win. So that's what matters.
Another difference that has come up is today most of the biggest news stories have been broken on social media. And then it comes to TV. Would you say digital platforms are your biggest competitors now, or other news channels?
All right, so I think that's more a, you know, I mean, it's people have different takes on that. Like I said, people don't remember where did they watch or see or read that story first. What matters is who is telling this story, and what matters is how they are telling this story, how credible it is. So yes, social media has sort of created the clutter or the crowd, and number of options are more, or people are overloaded with information. So actually it's good for people like us, because they are good, and people believe in us, and it's easier for someone who has been outstanding. So honestly, so I see it that way. So a good brand with good storytellers, experienced editors, and a unique strength to reach out to millions of people every day is actually a great strength. And that's what, you know, that's why you're seeing Zee News, you know, breaking the barriers, or number one ko palti khila rahe hain hafte ke baad hafte, hafte dar hafte. तो वो सब ऐसे नहीं हो रहा है वो सब इसलिए हो रहा है क्योंकि Zee News काम कर रहा है Zee News लोग को लोग पसंद कर रहे हैं
बट हाउ आर यू लेवरेजिंग डिजिटल फॉर Zee News
सॉरी
हाउ आर यू लेवरेजिंग द डिजिटल
वी हैव वेरी स्ट्रांग डिजिटल प्रेजेंस आई डोंट रियली गेट इनटू द नंबर्स बट लाइक zeenews.com इज वन ऑफ द ओल्डेस्ट न्यूज पोर्टल्स न्यूज वेबसाइट्स इन इंडिया एंड वी हैव 11 डिजिटल ब्रांड्स इन न्यूज or news-related topics, and they complement our portfolio. So we believe in TV and digital. We don't see a fight among them. We don't see one replacing the other. At Zee, we believe in digital and TV are here to stay. And you know, if you take US's example, where OTT is very hot or OTT is very popular, the numbers of television sets are not reducing drastically. What is reducing is the cable. So how you still watch news on TV, but not through a cable. It could be an OTT, it could be a smart TV, it could be through on the web, basically, but on TV. So that's not really a place to be or a reason to be worried about. What we should be worrying or what we should be careful about is how we tell stories and in times to come, how we cater to more and more news viewing communities, different age brackets. Like you said, someone is from 90s kid, has a different expectation from a news channel. Someone who a kid of today has a very, very different expectations. And that's why we follow the six lenses principle or philosophy of content selection, because we want to reach out to not just typical male leader in a family, but we also cater to homemakers, students, professionals, consumers, and the stories around citizens and farmers. So, you know, just about 15, 20 years ago, in a newsroom, people didn't care about farmers because they thought there were a couple of million cable viewers and they are all sitting in big cities. So these news channels were catering to them. But that's not the story now. Nearly 60% viewers come from rural areas, and that's actually a strength. We are reaching so many towns which are below 1 lakh population. So if you can cater to all these communities, your job is done, and that's what we are trying.
You know, a big problem associated with news channels today is the lack of differentiation of content. You know, how differently are you going to show a Sushma Swaraj receiving the Russian president? Everybody is going to cut to that feed, and unlike a GEC, you don't really have an option to create a premium content which the advertisers will be happy buying. So how does a news channel rise up to that particular challenge?
Right, I think that's a very valid concern. You have, let's say, you have one prime minister and that many news, so many news channels. And when prime minister is speaking something really important, we want to take it to, we want to carry it to our viewers. So yes, all these screens look the same, so to say, but that's where the work of a journalist or a news organization is seen. Because how you are treating, how you are analyzing, what are you talking about, what is unsaid in a speech, what was the timing, what is the occasion, why Prime Minister chose to say something at what occasion, from which, you know, which place, or things like that, or what follows that speech, or all that questions viewers have. And like I said, viewers are really, really smart these days. They can find out like this, if you are not true to your story, or if you're not, if you haven't done enough work on your story. So treatment and credibility really matters more than ever before.
You know, going back to GECs, you know, the kind of ad rates that GECs get and the ones that, you know, the Hindi news channels get, there's a zameen asman ka fark, as they say. But if reach was the only reason why they're commanding that much of a premium in ad rates, then why are English news channels getting much better rates than Hindi news channels?
So I'm glad you asked that question. I'm sure a lot of people who make decisions, who make buying decisions, are sitting here or will watch this video, hopefully. So that's not a new fight, but now we are trying to convince our advertiser about the engagement that we give when people's attention levels are very, very high is when they are watching a news item. Mm-hmm. So the engagement that we provide is very unique. I restrain from saying any names of GEC shows, because we also have a GEC in our portfolio. But, you know, so no Nagin or no Bahu or no Sas can give you that engagement that news can, because news is all about surprises, about people's everyday concerns. And numbers show amazing value you get by advertising on news platforms. Yes, sometimes selection of a right slot or a time schedule or a show is important, and we are here to help people on that. So if you're talking about pricing, yes, I think Indian news industry has a long way to go in terms of convincing advertisers about value of news media as an advertising medium. And I think people are growing up to, you know, and rising up to that situation where they see, and a lot of our partners have benefited, whether they are FMCG companies, or recently we're doing a big, big series of events and, you know, award series with SAP, for example. So why would they come and connect with Hindi news media? But they do. They're connecting with so many entrepreneurs in the heartland of country that they're finding it unbelievable how Hindi news media can connect them to so many future or potential buyers for SAP. So, and with due permission, I hope they don't mind naming them here. But, you know, it's a lot of work to be done on that side, but no complaints. I think we'll get our price. We're getting there anyways.
So it's the festive season for the news channels just going to begin with 5 state elections and 1 massive general elections. Tell me, what kind of growth do you see for Zee Media in the next 6 months?
Well, so we are a publicly listed company, so I'll be very careful in saying any growth projection. All those projections we talk about when we have our investor or analyst meets or in our annual reports. But in general, one estimate says the news as a genre in India is likely to double up in 2 to 3 years, if you know, and that's a big incentive. And but of course, how this growth will come and who will grab it first depends on capabilities and strengths. Some of them we have, but it will also depend on the consumer behavior, how much time people spend on digital or on TV, what time they do, how, what distribution medium they choose. Or will news media have that kind of marketing strength to be able to reach out to many more audiences? And I think some of it is going to change after December 29th, because the consumer will have the ultimate right of choosing channels a la carte on its distribution medium. He can pick and choose whichever channel he wants for declared price at a maximum retail price. So we see it as great growth opportunities, whether elections or no elections. Anyways, India is growing and there's lots to be, you know, conquered.
May you have a fabulous election season, and thank you so much for being with us today.
Thank you, Neeta. Thank you, Exchange for Media. Thank you.
I would request you both to please stay back. Neeta, I would request you to please hand over a token of appreciation to sir. Thank you, Mr. Dube, for being here with us this morning and for this very interesting session that we had. And thank you, Neeta, to you as well.